Get full episodes of The Damage Report as a podcast on iTunes and Android, and you can watch the live show every weekday on YouTube TV. Just a few weeks ago, we did a preview of the Brazilian election and primarily a profile of Jair Bolsonaro. The far right is, I think putting it mildly, candidate who it seemed like at that point was likely to go on to become president. Well, the election just happened and indeed he did win. And so now we get to take stock of what is likely to happen to Brazil and the people that live in Brazil as they greet as their new president, a guy who seems like a sociopath. And certainly an extremist, even if he doesn't make good on some of his past statements, some of which we will remind you of in this segment, he is very much an extremist. And that is consequential, not just for law and order issues in Brazil, but even things like management of the Amazon. Because he's a guy who seems extraordinarily ready to just clear it out, burn it down. And we know that that can have an extremely outsized effect on climate change. That's just one thing we're gonna talk more generally too. But he ended up winning, I think it was 55-45. So a good sized victory about what was expected. And now we'll be president. What do you think?
New day dawning
for Brazil.
Right. As soon as when I walked in this morning, like, oh, so Brazil, they elected Donald Trump. Okay, cool. Yeah. Interesting.
Yeah. Maybe more extreme than Donald Trump. We'll see. I don't know. Donald Trump gives him a run for his money.
We have no idea. Like, we don't know. There is no bar here in America. Mm-hmm. There is, no, I mean, because it changes
this
every
past week has been
week.
Has been something here.
Yeah.
But I want to talk a little bit about what's going on there. Many people are worried. You know, if you're an indigenous person in Brazil, he said awful things there. If you're Afro-Brazilian, just awful things that he has said about the community. If you're a member of the LGBTQ community in Brazil, he has talked about wanting to beat the gay out of his son if it turned out that his son was gay. So many people are worried. Those who oppose him use the slogan hashtag Elenau, not him. Because of his misogynistic comments, such as once reportedly telling a woman colleague in the legislature that she was, quote, not worthy of being raped by him. To be fair, he said, I'm not a rapist, but if I was a rapist, I wouldn't rape you because you don't deserve it. Which is something. Right. Now, in the run-up to the election, one of the things that helped to bolster what was already widespread support for him was, hey, here's a weird thing, fake news. In the months leading up to the election, Facebook shut down more than 100,000 WhatsApp accounts spreading conspiracy theories about Bolsonaro's opponents to voters across Brazil. And there was also a lot of violence and threats of violence against traditional media in Brazil as well. A nonprofit journalism group, the Brazilian Association of Investigative Journalism, documented at least 141 cases of threats and violence against reporters covering the presidential elections. In one case, a Bolsonaro supporter shot up a bus that was filled with reporters. Thankfully, no one was injured. But look, he's been very aggressive against the media. He talks about fake news. He has chosen, it's not CNN in this case, but there's one Brazilian newspaper that's considered sort of the Brazilian newspaper of record that he continually attacks and demonizes. So another page out of the Trump playbook.
Right, and it's kind of that same kind of game plan where you have a leader that says horrible things, that imply horrible things, but they swear they don't mean it. And just by chance, they have all these followers who are pushed to violence. Mm-hmm. And they don't want there to be, you know, any sort of connection to that. But I mean, at some point, you have to just acknowledge what's there.
Yeah, exactly. And the failure, constant failure to denounce these sorts of things or to do it in a, you know, a both sides sort of way.
Yeah.
That. Exactly. Now, one of the things, it seemed like he was going to win. We were very worried about it, obviously, but he won. One of the things that was scaring me in the lead up to it was the willingness of certain media outlets here in the US to whitewash his record. And we've got, I could have done, an entire hour on this, but we've plucked out a few choice bits of Western media helping to normalize Bolsonaro and his past. CBC News Alerts tweeted, Brazil's new president-elect Jair Bolsonaro is a right-winger who leans more towards open markets. This could mean fresh opportunities for Canadian companies looking to invest in the resource-rich country. So that is about as tone-deaf a take on this proto-dictator taking up the presidency of Brazil as I can imagine, especially when what they seem to be indicating is exactly the sort of thing like the stripping of the Amazon that we're worried about. But hey, they found a silver lining, so that's great.
The reporter who wrote that too also kind of tweeted in defending the article, like, you know, death threats are welcome, but just only from people who've read the whole thing. And I read the whole thing, and it's that's a perfect summary.
Exactly. That's the thing.
The article, it's pretty horrible.
Exactly. We can't go through the whole article all the time, but yeah, when it's consistent.
Did.
I know, that's
yeah,
what I'm saying. I'm saying on the show we can't.
Obviously, we do
in practice.
Right.
Like, for instance, Fox News, Brazil elects anti-establishment candidate Jair Bolsonaro as president. And the crazy thing is, I read that article. If you were to read through that, you would not be worried that he's going to stage a military coup or that he prefers dictatorship or all of that. It's weird. Wall Street Journal. So Wall Street Journal, when we initially did our reporting on Bolsonaro, it was in response to an extremely favorable Wall Street Journal op-ed about Bolsonaro. So they're back after the election in an article called Bolsonaro Takes Brazil. And I actually, in this case, want to read a little bit of the article for you. The woman who wrote this said, he was labeled a racist, a misogynist, a homophobe, a fascist, an advocate of torture, and an aspiring dictator. It ought to have been enough to sink the Bolsonaro candidacy, yet he prevailed. And it isn't hard to see why. Brazilians are in the midst of a national awakening in which socialism, the alternative to a Bolsonaro presidency, has been put on trial. And again, the only reference to his horrible past statements are in that quote, saying he was labeled that. Well, yes, he was labeled that, but he wasn't labeled that by me. First of all, he was labeled that by himself when he said that if his son was gay, he would beat him. That if you, what do you think about relationship interracial marriages? He said that's fornication. So when asked about dictatorship, he said, and this is a simple quote, simple enough for the writer in the Wall Street Journal to understand. He said, I would prefer a dictatorship. He said that he would institute a military coup on the first day if he became president. I guess now we'll see if he will in fact actually do that. He said that the only mistake that Brazil's former dictatorship made was that they preferred torture to killing. So I guess that was actually the torture thing was wrong there. He thought that they should have done less torture, more killing. The dictator of Chile should have killed more people, he said. And I think he said specifically it would have been improved if they'd rounded up and killed 30,000 people. So again, filtered through right-wing or center-right US media, that's labeling him things. No, that is what he is doing. That is what he is promising. And he's not some new anti-establishment guy. He's been in government for literally decades, and he's been saying these things for literally decades.
It's the same. It's this idea where you don't have to, your words aren't account. You don't have to be accountable for your words. Mm-hmm. You can say something and then say it means something else.
Yeah.
Or do you know what I mean? Like, you can say something completely racist, but don't call you a racist because that's not fair. So then you're labeled. It's kind of like calling yourself a nationalist and, you know, then being like, but that's not what I meant. Mm-hmm. I meant something else that I'm not going to explain, but that's what,
And it's bolstered by the fact that in these cults of personality, your fans will give you every benefit of the doubt beyond any reasonable limit. And the media, like, again, hashtag nothing matters. This person in the Wall Street Journal has read those quotes, but she has a narrative that she wants to push. So whatever, who cares if Brazil descends into a dictatorship? Maybe, like with the CBC, maybe the Wall Street Journal is primarily interested in opening up the Brazilian market more to US companies. God only knows. But if that means that some Brazilians need to be tortured or they need to be killed because this guy seems to have liked that for literally decades, who cares about that stuff? That's just labeling him homophobic, labeling him misogynistic because he says that he has very high standards for who he would rape. You go crazy doing this job because nobody cares about anything anymore. Nothing counts for anything. Is this woman going to lose her job because she wrote a fact-free profile of this incoming president?
Not at the Wall Street Journal.
She'll probably get a raise. Thank you very much for watching this clip from the Damage Report. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and ring the bell on YouTube to get notifications of our new videos. And of course, you can catch the full Damage Report live every weekday at 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific on TYT Network on YouTube TV.